It is currently 8:47 on Monday. I was up about 5 o'clock this morning, so it's been a long day so far. Currently taking my pre-workout right now. Still making room in my macros for some little bit of carbs. I think there's only like 2 or 3 carbs in there, but I need the extra caffeine this late at night. But I am not feeling it right now. I just kind of hit a wall earlier, so we'll see how this workout goes. It might be difficult to get it going, but I know I gotta stay really focused. I'm gonna try to do chest and like triceps or something, maybe a little bit of shoulders. We'll see how it goes, but it really depends on what happens when I get in there. Hopefully this caffeine will kick in a little bit and I'll get motivated a little bit more. But I tell you what, I am dog tired, and I'm used to doing these. I'm just, maybe it's the one day that the no carbs is trying to get to me, but we're gonna barrel through it and kind of force the issue as far as trying to get to the gym and focus on a good workout. So that's the main part, is what you have to focus on doing this keto diet. Is you're just, sometimes you might just be drained, and that is tonight. So we'll tape a little bit of the workout. We'll see how it goes. It's hard to do it just by myself in there, but certainly we'll shoot a little film afterwards to tell you how it went. We'll see how it goes. What you want? Alright guys, we're back. Tonight's workout was a success. We were good. I was worried about it before I left, but turns out everything worked out good. I did have energy when I got there. I had that pre-workout. I got on the bike for about 10-15 minutes before just kind of warm my body up. I started to feel the pump and that whole familiar feeling of let's do this. Got my earbuds in, started cranking some music, and we got it knocked out. So it was a good, productive workout. I was happy about that. But the one thing I will say, on my way to the gym, I'm kind of thinking to myself, what is going on? Is this my body telling me to stop this? Is this my body saying, no, you need carbs? You're too tired. You can't do this at night now with no carbs. This has been more than a week. Stop doing this to my body. Give me a milkshake with some fries and a hamburger with bacon. But it wasn't. My body wasn't telling me that. My body was just saying, it's 9 o'clock at night. You woke up at 5 o'clock. I don't want to be here right now. And that's told me that before. So basically I was wondering, is this stuff safe for me? Am I okay? So it kind of made me think, am I okay? Is this going to be all right for me to do this long term? I was kind of curious if it was going to affect anything, to be honest with you. So what I did when I came home is I hopped on the internet and I did a little bit more research on this diet. As far as long term effects, and my physical performance. The two things that I'm most worried about, obviously, being I don't call myself an athlete anymore. I don't do anything besides work out, but if I want to go somewhere and shoot hoops, I want to be able to be
competent enough to shoot a basketball. So I do have young kids, so I like to run around with them sometimes too. So I want to be able to play sports with them too, just to play around. But I was curious about my long-term health as far as a lot of this stuff. A lot of this research I found on the National Center of Biotechnology. A couple of studies that they were done from this team right here. I won't even try to get in these guys' names, but thank you for all this group right here. A lot of PhDs and MDs and BSCs, whatever those are. Basically did research on a 24-week study of the ketogenic diet as far as obese patients. They had 83. They went through the whole thing in 24 weeks. They said that all the good cholesterol went up, the bad cholesterol went down, triglycerides went down, their weight went down. So they basically concluded that the diet is safe. They tested everything before and after, blood levels, everything like that. They determined that it's something that they wouldn't be worried about people doing regularly. Now again, how much more research has been done as far as even more long-term than 24 weeks? I'm sure there's people out there that have been doing a lot longer than that, that live just the ketogenic lifestyle. That's just what they do. And there are people that are probably fine doing that, but every individual is different. But according to this study, they said they think it's safe for a long period of time. They didn't specify what long period meant. But basically, I think it would determine how your body's telling you what you need to do. Secondly, the big other thing I was really concerned about and thinking about the more and more I'm starting to get into this diet is my physical performance overall. I know some of the things have cut back as far as my rep ranges, being as strong as I used to be, as far as getting in the 12 to 15 reps. I definitely can feel that the glycogen level of my muscles have decreased as far as that. Because sometimes it just gets to the point where I just can't push it anymore. But the heavier weights for me seem easier as far as previous. Like, I don't think I'm stronger than I was before because of the diet, but I'm focusing on more sets and heavier weight. So I think that's definitely helping. Basically, the study done by Stephen D. Feeney, I guess that's how you say it. Study done in 2004. They wanted to check the ketogenic diet and overall physical performance. And they basically go on to explain this whole thing about back in the 1800s, carbs weren't really a thing. I mean, people were hunters most of the time. That's what they did. That's their whole day, was going out and to find food to live. So they didn't have carbs to eat. They didn't have chips they could munch on. They didn't have burgers. They didn't have French fries. I mean, they just didn't have the carbs. I'm sure they had grain and corn and stuff like that, but some of these places, they couldn't grow anything. It was freezing cold, so all they would go out was, they would try to hunt. They live off fat and protein. That's what they live off of. And they lived. They were fine. So, like I said, the human body will adapt to a lot of things, and just because you don't eat carbohydrates doesn't mean your body won't manufacture them themselves with the stuff that you eat. So the study that they looked at was basically, they did some, I think it was a VO2 max. Basically the aerobic capacity of the workout, and they determined that basically stayed the same as far as your workouts, as long as you're aerobic. If you're anaerobic, you might want to stick to some carbohydrates. The as far as weightlifting or sprinting, stuff like that, you're going to tap in your glycogen levels a lot quicker. So you want to probably keep those carbs in your diet. It will be hard to, maybe that first lift or that first sprint won't be as bad, but you get in the second sprint, third sprint, your third lift or fourth lift at a meet, you are going to get winded for sure. I can definitely feel that, but like I said, the weights being heavy right now, lifting those aren't the issue. It's when you start to get that third, fourth, fifth, sixth set, you can feel the weakness starting to take in as far as some of your levels. But overall, I feel really strong still. I can't complain. I was more curious if it had something to do with my testosterone levels because I felt so strong. I looked into that. A lot of stuff has been determined that the keto diet can actually decrease your testosterone. And say nothing was scientific about that. That was just a bunch of different websites. I'm not going to go to those things. It's just a bunch of just Googling and searching and stuff like that. I didn't do a lot of digging as far as that, but everything that I found says that it can actually lower. But if you Google foods that will raise your testosterone, a lot of the foods that you eat are on that list. So I think it has to do with individuals and how they eat and how they work out and basically their lifestyle before the ketogenic diet even got kicked into their bodies as far as what they're doing anyway before that. So that's my take on it. Whether you like it or not, I don't care. That's how I feel. But overall, I still feel great on the diet. I can't complain. Everything's going good, so we're going to keep grinding it out. Tomorrow we're going to post probably another video back at the gym. If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, if you guys think I'm an idiot, if you guys think I'm a genius, that ain't going to happen. But if you think I'm an idiot, post something below. Like I said, questions, comments, always hit up the subscribe button, like, all that good stuff, share with your friends. Peace. See you tomorrow.